So my name is John Ruberto. I'm the product development leader for QuickBooks Enterprise Solutions. We're a product in Intuit. You may know Intuit from our brands, QuickBooks, TurboTax, Quicken, and Mint.com are our major products. With QuickBooks, we have two different code bases. One is Java code base, the other is a C++ primarily with some C# components in there. We're using Coverity primarily for the Java code and the C++ code, and we're just getting started with the C# analysis. During system testing, we found that over 60% of our defects were actually coding errors. These were errors that the developers made in simply translating the requirements into code. And we did some brainstorming with the developers on how could we reduce the coding errors so that we can get through system testing phase faster and more efficiently. What we did was we brainstormed and we found that developers wanted to improve the unit testing and code review practices. Those were the two most powerful methods, but we are already using unit testing and code review, and we're still getting a lot of defects escaping. So we dug deeper, and we found that static analysis is a great complement to those two practices. So the three practices taken together have proven to be very efficient at removing the coding errors. We built our process for static analysis using Coverity to notify the developers as soon as the scan is complete. The Coverity scripts will send an email to the developer with a link back into the tool. That shows the exact line of code that failed, and the Coverity tool provides some good educational material to describe why that's a problem. And developers receive these emails within hours of them checking in a code that has a problem. The result of this rapid feedback cycle was that the developers were getting better at writing code. After a few months of using Coverity and getting this rapid feedback, the code they were developing was twice as good as it was in the beginning. So once the developers were comfortable with the results that Coverity was providing, we decided to attack the backlog. And to attack the backlog, we wanted to give the developers some fun incentives to actually fix the problems. So we did what we called the Coverity Olympics. We did this during the London Olympic Games. It just so happened to be at the same time we did a hardening release and we did the Coverity Olympics. So for every major bug that a developer fixed, they got 10 points. For every minor bug, they got 5 points. And for every bug they triaged is not a problem, they got 1 point. And at the end of the 2-week period, we gave out gold, silver, and bronze medals. So after we fully deployed Coverity and Coverity was finding these coding errors for us, what we found was it was much more efficient to fix the problems when they occurred and not during system testing. And this was one of the elements that allowed us to reduce the amount of time that we took to do system testing, which allowed us to release code faster to our customers and more often. So it shortened the full development lifecycle.